7 years he has spread his genetics. He has tested Carrie's will, and she has passed on questionable shots. But today, a new hand has been dealt. We all have our stories to tell, tales of the ones that got away, and the ones that never. This is the story of a buck named Forklift, and the hunter named Carrie. They're about to play the game of hearts. For Carrie, it is a test of skill, endurance, and patience. For she has waited for the chance of a lifetime, hoping that a king will walk her way. And you need heart to go the distance when you're hunting a king. With Forklift, the stakes are much higher. If he wins, he will live out his life in paradise. But if he makes one wrong move, the game will be over, for his heart will beat no more. They say he's a wild man who likes to let her fly and say there's no one like him. That, I promise, ain't no lie.
I feel alive when I throw the spear.
For he's a hardcore hunter who kills with stick and strings. Like a croc, he'll wait for hours. 'Cause killing's just his thing. He's got a gun, as do most of his friends. But try and take it from him, and you'll likely wind up dead. He hunts with spears and blowguns. But he loves to shoot his bow. And when his arrow cuts the distance, the blood begins to flow. He trained his kids to hunt, so that's just what they do. They're lethal with a bow, and their mama's deadly too. Critters tried to kill him, and he nearly killed himself. But dying's for dead men. Oh. And that card ain't been dealt. He's still out there living, the guy who lets her fly. He'll probably be shooting arrows the day he finally dies. So if you're searching for a killer, the baddest predator beneath the sun, you can stop your looking. For you just found him. I'm the one. It's the game of hearts. Through the trials of life, Forklift was finally filmed at the ripe old age of 4.5 years. It was his first encounter with man. Rattled nearly into range, but he held his distance. He nearly took the bait, but he was wiser than most and survived his fourth year of life. After that, he had vanished until the following winter. Then reappeared in a soybean food plot that Carrie had left for him. But he was wise and stayed to the edge of the food plot, keeping his distance from the tree line where danger lurked. His crown of horns now added to Carrie's drive to kill him. Yet once again, he would vanish, not to reappear until the rut of the following year. His brothers were on the move, and Carrie had already tagged one of the few that had survived the deadly disease of EHD. She now wondered if Forklift was still alive, hoping their paths would finally cross, where she could end the game once and for all. A fog was rolling in from the west when she finally laid eyes on her giant opponent. But he too had been watching. Still, she beckons him to come play the game. But again, he wins another round. It was merely a week later when Forklift walked to the edge of death once again. He's just outside of her range. He's becoming careless, moving about in the daylight. So she hunts him at every crossing, scrape, and food plot. But once again, he has vanished. Carrie is now another year older, as is Forklift. At least she hopes so. He would be 7. That's very old. She can only hope. It's a long shot to see a big buck on opening day. But it's a ritual she'll never give up.
Them trees. He's coming at you. He's a freaking giant.
Forklift is now a giant. He has won every hand that has been dealt, and his antlers tower above him. He's a world-class deer. But winning for so long has made him careless. He feeds oblivious to the danger that awaits. She has played the game of hearts long enough. And the prize is now before her. And she is ready. The prize is before her and about to come her way. Don't try to be like me, for I'm old, crazy, and have nothing to lose. Brought to you by SKB, keep your travels safe. Bass Pro, Oneida Bows, and Mossy Oak, Relentless Pursuit's first choice in camouflage. Drowsy from the long day's rest, Forklift stands enjoying the pleasures of the fall. He notices another pleasure has stepped into the field, but he ignores her. Finally, Forklift figures he better check her out, just to see what kind of mood she's in. It's probably too early in the fall, but you never know. You might just get lucky. But it appears his luck is about to run out.
Here we go, baby. Here we go. You just pick that spot, you just squeeze that trigger. She's gonna bring him right under you.
He realizes his mistake, for the putrid smell of man brushes his nostrils, sending adrenaline throughout his body. She waits for the perfect shot. But quickly, he tucks his tail, then slides back into his lair. You're watching the raw story of Forklift. And it's brought to you by Mossy Oak. Again, Forklift has vanished, but reappears November 11th, near a mock scrape where Carius set a camera. It's a trick. Nearly a mile from where she almost killed him, Forklift has left a clue. It's been 4 years that Carrie and Forklift have played the game. 241 days she has spent searching, waiting, hunting her prey. Forklift has grown old, nocturnal most of his life. He has learned how to stay alive. He's had his brushes with death, but still has fared well. Seven years he has spread his genetics. He has tested Carrie's will, and she has passed on questionable shots. But today, a new hand has been dealt. Thank you. The wind isn't perfect, but it's all she's got. And Carrie eases into position and prepares for the shot. He was 45 yards, but she wanted him a little bit closer. We owed him that much. And as Forklift turned to leave, we both realized that he had won the game of hearts.
From the very beginning, man has been a hunter.